TJ Watt. Oh, my goodness.
It's TJ Watt.
Oh, that was a great play.
What a play by TJ Watt.
Wilson is taken down. TJ Watt. TJ Watt comes up with it on the sack by the Steelers and the strip. That is TJ Watt with an end zone pick.
How do you even begin to sum up 2019 for you? Is that the feeling?
Where do we start? I mean, I had, like I said, I hate saying I had so much fun because of how the season ended and how the record and not making the playoffs, but I did. I had a lot of fun with this team and the amount of adversity and obstacles we were able to overcome as a team. And defensively, I feel like we took a lot of steps in the right direction and forcing the takeaways. We did a lot of things that we set out to do this year, and but it wasn't enough. And I think that's what's so humbling about the game of football is it's never truly going to be enough, and I'm never going to be satisfied. So here we are having this conversation while other people are getting prepared for games, and that's always a crappy feeling.
I feel like I asked you this exact same question last year, but how do you get over the fact you didn't make the playoffs and you're kind of starting from scratch again? And unfortunately, that's just how it goes, but.
Yeah, I think you have to have a short memory in this game, and that's week to week, but also year to year. So even if we went out and had a phenomenal year this year, you have to have a short memory for the next year. And, but you can't not watch the tape. I think a lot of us will take some time to have to ourselves and kind of reflect and relax from the season, and then get back to watching film. And there are a lot of positives in a lot of the stuff that we did this year, but there's a lot that we all want to get better at individually and collectively. So just have to go back to the drawing board and get better for next year.
Being named the Steelers team MVP for this season, what do the coaches tell you moving forward for next year that can help you better prepare yourself?
I think just continually take steps in the right direction, individually and collectively, and just be a better leader for this team. Going into my fourth year, it's absolutely wild how fast time goes by. And I mean, I'm a true Pittsburgh resident now. It's just wild how life takes you so many different ways. And I couldn't be happier to be here and to be able to lead a group of guys in that locker room. I just want to continue to take steps in the right direction as far as my leadership and being more vocal and doing a lot more of those kind of things.
I remember when I asked you who you voted for team MVP, and you said Minkah, kind of like I was crazy for even asking. But I guess give me your thought process of why that was an easy choice for you.
Yeah, Minkah's a dog. He came in and his football IQ was through the roof. You didn't really have to explain much to him. You would kind of show him a play, and for the first time, and he'd be like, yeah, I got it. And then you'd explain him a little bit more, and he'd be like, no, I got it. You don't have to tell me more. All right, geez, you got it. And you go out to the practice field, and he's always stretching. He's always doing extra running stuff. And then you go out and see him perform, and it kind of makes sense because a lot of people don't get to see the behind the scenes of all this. And that's, I kind of have the view of a fan in here because I like to observe how other guys approach the game. And to be able to see Minkah and how he gets ready week in, week out, and then it kind of translates over to the game field, and there's no question as to why he's so successful. And he came in here and turned a lot of things around for us, and was a playmaker.
He's so quiet. Is he quiet to you guys?
He opens up. He's a lot like me. I'm very quiet to people, but once you kind of open him up, he's very outgoing and. We're just getting to it, so hopefully he doesn't open up too much more because he's already talking a lot of smack on the Beano board and all that stuff. So.
I believe you said that he takes so many notes in meetings that you kind of sit next to him and look over his shoulder.
Yeah.
What is he writing down that maybe other people aren't hearing or seeing?
Sometimes he's just doodling, but other times he's actually taking notes. Like Coach T will be up there talking, and also he'll like write something down. Like, are you really writing that down? Like, it's not noteworthy. And he'll have like everything. He just writes stuff down, and I think some guys just learn differently. I think that's part of the NFL is trying to find out how each guy learns. And he seems to be a sponge and writes everything down so he remembers it. And I like to take notes, but this guy takes a ton of notes. And sometimes he'll be like, I'm just writing today, chill. Because I say so many little snarky comments to him. But it's fun. It's because he also makes me want to take more notes too, just because I'm next to him and I'm like, man, I should probably pay more attention here.
So you're definitely gravitating towards Minkah, just in his personality. When you go back and watch film, what are you doing? Are you sitting on a couch doing it? Are you watching every single play? What's your process when you go back and review an entire season?
Yeah, I'll be on the couch relaxing. I'm not going to be up in,
a dark room.
Up in a dark room or anything like that. But, I think possibly have pen and paper and write out a bunch of pros and cons of things that I did throughout the year. But I think you kind of break it down as to run defense. And then the next day you watch pass. And
okay.
Then, break down potential matchups, like a lot of divisional opponents to see guys you'll be facing again, to see what was effective and what wasn't, and pass rush plan and all that stuff, and just overall assess how everything went for the year and be very true with myself and not try to sugarcoat things.
I know you said you appreciated the team MVP because that was voted on by your teammates, and you didn't want to talk about possibly being in the running for the Defensive Player of the Year, but that has to mean something that you were in this conversation, an award your brother has won multiple times, to be the best of the best. Everybody in the league is here for a reason and strives to be that. Does it mean anything just to be in that conversation?
I don't know. I don't even know if I'm in the conversation because there's no...
You're in the conversation.
There's no, like, set finalists and everything.
Right.
So it's nice, but like I said, no matter what happens, I'm never satisfied. And
yeah.
I mean, I've been to that award show many times for my brother. I've seen him win it 3 times. So I always leave motivated more than ever. And it would be awesome to win that award. And it's a team award. It always is. And there's a lot of plays that I left out there this year, and I'm sure a lot of guys can say that. And I can promise you I'm more hungry now than I ever have been, so I'm very motivated for 2020.
You talked about the defense and how much fun you guys had. So many first-rounders like yourself are on it. Who's somebody on this defense that you're really looking forward to having a big year in 2020?
Devin. You talk about guys taking that year one, year two jump. And I think he had over 100-some tackles. So that's probably more than my career. So he was getting up and down off the ground a lot this year. But just the way that he's able to fly around, and I'm excited for him to take the vocal step on the field next year. So stay tuned for all that.